You're listening to Spring River Chronicle. Audio on the go.
First National Banking Company. Get checking that pays with Super Plus Checking at FNBC.
Cherokee Village House Fire Ruled Not Accidental by Lauren Siebert. A fire at 177 Pottawatomie was found to be not accidental, according to a report received by the Cherokee Village Fire Department on August 14th after a month-long investigation. The fire in question occurred on April 5th and initially had no determined cause. In a report after the fire, Cherokee Village Fire Department Fire Code Inspector Lieutenant Russell Tanner stated that, "I am at this time unable to say what the cause of the fire is." Lieutenant Tanner's report was sent to the insurance company for further review, as are all reports in such cases. The details of the fire began with the initial call to Cherokee Village Fire Department at 6 a.m. on April 5th. When firefighter Tony Rook first arrived on the scene, he saw the residence of Brian Justin completely engulfed in flames. "When I arrived at the scene, I assessed the situation and called for backup," Rook said, adding that, "I looked for signs of people, but there was no vehicle in the drive, and there didn't appear to be anyone at home." Lieutenant Richard Deckard was second on the scene. When Deckard arrived, Rook was already running hoses and trying to extinguish the flames. Deckard immediately began hooking up to the fire hydrant and assisting Rook. Chief Mike Taylor arrived shortly thereafter, along with 15 other firefighters. With a well-orchestrated effort, the team was able to have the fire out by 8 a.m. "Fortunately, no one was hurt," Fire Chief Mike Taylor said. Tanner performed an investigation into the cause of the blaze. After taking photographs during the initial firefighting effort, he returned at 11:30 a.m. to collect any evidence he could find, as well as to check for hot spots and fire extension. Later that day, Tanner called the homeowner to gather more information. According to Jessen, the homeowner, "It had been cold during the night. I had added a couple sticks to the fire just before leaving," he continued. "It was around 4:30, 4:45 a.m. I left the insert just like I always have done, so I'd have some coals and a warm house when I returned." Tanner's report also noted that there was a gas stove on the wall in the kitchen from which a line had been disconnected. Although the fire department normally shuts off the gas at the scene of any fire, it is unknown when the gas was shut off, either before or after the fire. Although details in the insurance investigation are not available, when something is listed as other than accidental, take that as literally meaning not an accident, said Chief Taylor, adding that it also means that the next step will likely be legal action.